कंटेंशन ऑफ मोहम्मद आरिफ खान लर्नेड सीनियर एडवोकेट असिस्टेड बाय मोहम्मद असलम खान एडवोकेट फॉर द पेटिशनर वाज दैट द विल डेटेड 4/7/1991 एग्जीक्यूटेड बाय हसन इन फेवर ऑफ द पेटिशनर एंड रजिस्टर्ड एज पर लॉ वाज ड्यूली प्रूव्ड बाय एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ वन ऑफ द अटेस्टिंग विटनेसेस बट द सेम हैज बीन disbelieved by the courts below only on the ground it excluded the natural legal heirs and also that there were certain discrepancies in the will such as the last page appeared to have been added subsequently containing the details of the holdings of Hasan whereas according to him such details were mentioned on the first page of the will itself full stop. In support of his contention, Sri Khan relied upon various decisions which shall be referred later while discussing the merits of the case full stop. He also contended that one of the reasons which weighed heavily with the consolidation courts was that the will was executed at a time when the testator did not have the right to transfer his holding, whereas according to him, firstly, will is not a transfer but a mode of succession. Secondly, it is well settled that will being effective on the death of the testator, if by then he had acquired transferable rights over the land sought to be bequeathed, then the will could not be held to be invalid merely because at the time of its execution the testator did not have such rights as the rights over the land in question as on the date of death had to be seen full stop. In this regard, he relied upon various decisions of this court which shall be referred in the latter part of the judgment full stop. Lastly, Sri Khan contended that the petitioner had filed an application for getting the signatures of Hasan as appearing on the will examined by a handwriting expert, but the said application was never decided and findings were recorded as to the validity of the willing, ignoring the same, which according to him was an apparent error committed by the courts below full stop para. On the other hand, Sri Ajmal Khan, learned counsel appearing for the contesting private respondents, the sons of Hasan contended that Section 170 of the UP ZA and LR Act barred the execution and registration of such a bill by a sirdar or a bhumidar with non-transferable rights. Therefore, in the face of such statutory bar, the bill could not be read in evidence, nor could the petitioner claim any title based thereon full stop. According to him, execution of such a will was also contrary to the object contained in sections 195 and 198 of UP ZA and LR Act, which was to grant land to landless laborers for their subsistence and livelihood full stop, relying upon a decision of this court reported in 2006 under bracket 1 JLR 789 Man Singh Adil Collector Muzaffarnagar or Ors. He contended that if transfer of land in such a way is permitted, it will defeat the very object for which the land has been granted to a landless laborer and will encourage their exploitation full stop.